I was teaching third grade in Riceville, Iowa. I walked into my house. The telephone was ringing. I answered the telephone. My sister said, "Is your television on?" I said, "No." She said, "You better turn it on." I said, "Why?" She said, "Because they shot him." I said, "Who do we shoot this time?" And she said, "Martin Luther King Jr." And I couldn't for a minute think that the world was still spinning. There was no way I could explain the ignorance and the lack of civility and the unchristian behavior that this country was exhibiting with the killing of Martin Luther King Jr. And I was crying and I was upset and I was angry, I was furious. And I got my husband's supper ready. He worked at Oliver that night at that time. And when he came home, I said, "Tomorrow, brown-eyed people are going to be on the top in my classroom and blue-eyed people are going to be on the bottom." He said, "Jane, you'll lose your job." I said, "If I lose my job for teaching something they need to know, I don't want a teacher." So I went to school. The first student in my classroom came in. They said, "Hey, they shot that king last night. Why'd they shoot that king?" I said, "We're going to talk about that." And I asked those kids what they knew about black people. And they knew every negative stereotype that I had ever heard about black people and some that had never occurred to me. And I said, "Do you kids have any idea how it would feel to be something other than white in this country?" "No." "Would you like to know?" "Yeah, yeah." It was like, "We've already gotten out of spelling and handwriting. Keep this broad talking. We don't have to learn anything all day long." So I said, "Okay, today, we're going to judge people by the color of their eyes. Brown-eyed kids are going to be on top the first day of this exercise." They said, "What do you mean?" I said, "I mean, blue-eyed people aren't as smart as brown-eyed people. They aren't as clean as brown-eyed people. They aren't as civilized as brown-eyed people." And at that point, little brown-eyed Debbie, sitting in the front row, and this had only been 3 minutes, looked up at me and said, "How come you're the teacher if you got them blue eyes?" And I thought, oh, this is how this works, isn't it? Here, this little 8-year-old girl can attack her teacher who has been to college, finished high school, and she has the right to attack me now because she has the right color eyes and I have the wrong color eyes. I couldn't believe what happened that day. A tall, blonde, beautiful, brilliant girl came into my room in February, reading at the 6th grade level in 3rd grade. She had never multiplied. I taught her how to multiply the first 15 minutes of math class. On the day she had the wrong color eyes, that brilliant little girl made mistakes in reading, made mistakes in spelling, and forgot how to multiply. She came in from recess crying. I said, "What's going on here?" As she walked across the playground, two brown-eyed Debbies and a brown-eyed Cindy stepped up behind her, reached up, struck her across the back with her forearm, and when Carol turned around, Debbie said to her, "Now you have to apologize to me for getting in my way, because I'm better than you are." And Carol apologized and came in crying. No person of any age will ever leave my presence with those attitudes unchallenged. I can't change your attitude, but I can challenge your attitude, and you have to prove to me that so-called white people are superior to everybody else on the face of the earth, and you can't do it because it isn't true. People are wondering whether what she did 52 years ago should be relevant today. In 52 years, we should have solved this problem. I am so determined that we change the education system in this country. I am so determined that we change what we're educating people to believe. There's only one race on the face of the earth, and that's the human race. Once we get that into the heads of our legislators, we'll have a different kind of law written. Once we get that into the heads of the police, we'll have a different law enforcement. Once we get that into the heads of educators, we'll have different education. We thought we stopped Martin Luther King Jr.'s dream by killing him. His dream is more alive now than it was when he was living, and you have proof of it by what's going on in every major city in the United States of America right now. Racism isn't about skin color. It's about white fear of different kinds of people. It's not skin color that's the problem. The skin color isn't the problem. You can't change skin color. You can change attitudes.